So, new Bleach information and video game news in regards to BBS and a little reaction for you as well. Watch throughout this video where we discuss about Bleach anime news as well as Bleach Brave Souls from K-Lab. Let's get into it. It is that time of the week where we do have some leaked images in regards to this week's issue of Weekly Shonen Jump. And while there wasn't much in this week's issue, so to say, more so promoting the Akita version of the Bleach exhibition, I can't ever say that word. The main focus of that page was again selling tickets and making sure everyone was aware of it, as well as selling the art book booklet of all the illustrations with the comments with Kubo's obviously comments of the images that he drew along with them, as well as the new images as well. So you'll be able to buy that again on July 8th, something along those lines. But anyway, let's get into the main bread and butter of it, because usually at the end of an issue of Weekly Shonen Jump, you have the contents page or the preview page. And at the preview page, instead of saying the average like Bleach game news or the Bleach X news, which is the exhibition, we actually finally have Bleach TV news, which, when this is translated, which translates to Bleach News, TV anime, Bleach Millennium Blood, new information and original painting exhibition, which we already knew of anyway. And there's obviously going to be some new information in regards to the Thousand Year Blue War Arc. Now, one of my biggest fears about the upcoming anime expo, which we talked about in the video prior to this one, is that I felt like they were just going to bring on the voice actors, kind of confirm who's going to reprise their roles and talk about the licensing maybe, and then show the pre-animated preview that we've seen in December. But it seems to me that considering what this Shonen Jump page says for the preview for next week, which officially comes out on a Monday, but we usually get on a Thursday, so just before the event itself, we may get spoiled, so I'll try my best maybe not to do a video on it, but we'll see how it goes. And the reason why I am talking about this specific portion of the magazine in this video today is because I do get a lot of people asking if we're going to be seeing a new PV. As much as I like actually being kept in suspense and not knowing pretty much anything, it seems to be the case. It seems to be leading towards it. And I don't really know, but it seems to be going in that direction in terms of Kubo's comment, in terms of how Shonen Jump are promoting that there is going to be new information. Goes to say to me that, yeah, a PV might actually be shown at Anime Expo. And of course, we are going to be live reacting to it. And of course, we are going to be doing a discussion afterwards, or a little breakdown, or even maybe a live stream. So yeah, what do I think is going to be happening at Anime Expo? I think we're going to get a PV. I think we're going to get the voice actors come back. I think we're going to get the licensing of where it's going to be streamed, whether it's Crunchyroll, Disney, Netflix, and Amazon Prime. Who knows? We're going to get Kubo's message and maybe some other little tidbits we weren't really expecting. So that's my quick overall thoughts on that. So let's talk about Bleach Brave Souls. And before I do get into that, we're going to watch the new live reaction. Well, I'm going to be live reacting to the preview for the 7th anniversary of Bleach Brave Souls. And if you have or are new to the channel, you would know that I have been making content on this game since 2015. I think that's 7 years, right? Yeah, since the Japanese first pre-registration release, and it's pretty insane. So I am going to live react to this now, and we're going to have a little guess in the comment section down below of who you think the character is. Rain. We're going to go for the years. Okay. Rain. Rain's the theme. Translate? I'm going to translate that in a minute. 2022, obviously. It's not going to be next year. Okay. Okay. I want to translate that right quick. Right, so I've got the kanji on screen right now of the translation in before the English version is out. But okay, so from looking at it, it seems to be the theme of is rain. And I'm thinking in my head who uses rain. Obviously, Kayan uses rain, but also, because I know I was talking about this with Arenyero, a BBS YouTuber, you should go check him out, as well as Spite, shout out to them, that from what I've noticed and from what you see in that timeline, our anniversary characters of either Ichigo or opponents that Ichigo has faced. And my initial kind of prediction before obviously making this video and before seeing this video, obviously, is that I thought, okay, it's either going to be Grimmjow or it's going to be Ginjo, because they kind of fit the sequence of Ichigo's villains or Ichigo's adversaries that he's fought. But considering that this is Rain, and I'm trying to keep it Ichigo focused because that's what they tend to do. Yeah, just a pause you right there, James, from the past. You might have fucked up a little bit because this is the image from the website that I thought changes every year. Guess it doesn't. There's the characters that you're about to say don't actually show up in this list at all. However, I do think variations of Ichigo are still a plausibility. So the characters that I'm about to mention, if you carry on watching the rest of the video, still plausible. I think maybe, seeing as they like to dabble in beyond resurrections and beyond Bankai, so who knows, I could still be right. However, I'm going to quickly change my mind to considering that there is a bit of a road going towards the past variations of the anniversary. Maybe it's kind of using the Kisuke with the umbrella over Ichigo, using that road that they are on when Kisuke goes to save Ichigo as it's raining. That's a plausibility that springs to my mind. There's also the Kaien and Rukia thing as well, which I don't think it is Rukia because, again, I don't really see a single banner for an anniversary. I know single banners happen, but usually it's with two characters in like week one and week two. So, again, Rukia is a possibility, but that's more icy rather than rain. But again, the Kaien thing, so I mean, possible. You could also say Gin and Rongiku because they have a sad little thing as well with like when so-and-so died and she was crying, and you could say, let's say the rain's like symbolic. But I think considering that this is talking about one person and it's talking about a resounding pride, I think it might be Kisuke, maybe? I don't know. I think it's Kisuke. Second notion, Rukia. Rukia's quite prideful. But again, I think it's too obvious. But anyway, yeah, that's kind of who I think it is now. But then again, I still kind of stick to what I'm about to say from past James, so give him a listen, because you might like it, and K-Lab might be fucking with you, so who knows, but yeah, enjoy the rest of the video. This is definitely Zangetsu, considering that the kanji is resounding pride, and Zangetsu is very prideful of himself, or Hollow Ichigo is, but this definitely seems either Zangetsu-ish, or Tenza Zangetsu, and I'm leaning more towards Tenza Zangetsu because of the inner world where he's talking about how he hates rain. So that's my prediction. My prediction, Tenza Zangetsu. I don't think it's Kaien. I think it's a bit silly, but I do think it's either, if we're gonna get a double banner, it's like we did with the Mugetsu and Hollow Vastar Lodai Ichigo. It's either gonna be Zangetsu or just simply Tenza Zangetsu, or both. So that's my kind of speculation in regards to that. And that would be really cool. Yeah, I just wanted to quickly talk about the 7th anniversary of BBS2. If you guys generally like that reaction or my thoughts in general, I think BBS is a very important part of Bleach's continuation of coming back. It helped really revitalize the revenue in source for Shueisha, showing that there is still a fandom and whatnot. So I have to give big gratitude to BBS. And though I do still play it, and I played it to get the anime to come back, there is a lot of investment that I have put into the game. And to be honest, it's not a bad game. You know, to go on for 7 years is quite a humongous achievement in and of itself, and to see the support that this game continues to bring, especially through its light novels, hopefully shows Shueisha that there is still a want and a need and a desire for it. So I did want to, when I woke up this morning and I was thinking about the anniversary and I saw that the trailer dropped, I did feel the need to get up and make a video, because I do feel BBS is important, especially within the ecosystem of Bleach. And I'm extremely excited to see where this goes going forward. And I'm very excited to see what BBS, Bleach Brave Souls, and K-Lab do with its IP. If you want to see more videos like this on Bleach Brave Souls, I can definitely do a collab with some of the BBS streamers and talk about, you know, the future of BBS. And if you like this, I'll also do a reaction to not only the gameplay of the new character for the anniversary, which is on the July 23rd, by the way, but also to the promotional video that they do as well. But I don't really expect this video to get that much views. So again, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of Anime Expo as well, and what we're going to get, as well as the Bleach Brave Souls game. Other than that, smash a like on the video, do support as always, and good morning from when I'm recording this, because yeah, kind of sporadic. Yeah, with that being said, you guys of course have this fine David Hansen, as always, people. Peace out.